Tecton enables data teams to build robust pipelines that transform raw data into highly valuable assets like features, embeddings, and prompts for AI applications. At the core of any Tecton pipeline lies a critical component, the feature view object. A feature view in Tecton is a key building block for developing, managing, and productionizing features. Feature views streamline feature production with just a few configuration steps and a single CLI command. It's designed with performance, accuracy, and consistency in mind, supporting feature computations in both online and offline environments. With feature views, Tecton takes care of everything, from backfilling and orchestration to job and table management, performance optimizations, monitoring, and more. This means data teams can focus on building and refining features without worrying about infrastructure. Feature views in Tecton come in three main types, each designed to handle specific data transformation and feature publishing needs. Batch feature views handle data transformations from batch sources, processing data at scheduled intervals, and publish them to the online or offline feature stores, making them available for use in model training or online inference. Stream feature views operate on data from streaming sources in near real time, which allows them to deliver fresh feature values to the online store. Stream feature views are powerful because they run the same transformations in both real-time and offline environments. Real-time feature views transform data at the time of request, which is especially useful for features that need to be computed dynamically and can't be pre-computed. Let's dive into the core components that make up a feature view definition in Tecton. These components determine how raw data is transformed into the necessary assets for AI applications. First up is sources. This configuration points to raw data sources that the feature view will read from, providing the initial input data for transformations. This could be a batch source, stream source, request source, or even a feature view in certain scenarios. Next, we have entities. Entities represent primary keys for features in both batch and stream feature views. They also allow us to organize features around key business concepts, like users, merchants, or products, making it easier to discover and manage features. The features list specifies the individual features that will be computed from raw or transformed data. In Tecton, there are multiple types of features that can be created, each designed to meet different analytical needs. Attribute features are simple values within a column of the transformed data. Tecton stores these values and supports time travel lookups for accurate data retrieval during model training and inference. Aggregate features perform time-windowed aggregations across columns in the data. Tecton manages these computations to ensure they're both efficient and up-to-date. Aggregate features offer flexible options for different windowing and grouping needs and are supported for both batch and stream feature views. Embedding features compute word embeddings on string-type columns. Tecton supports built-in open-source models or custom word embedding models for this type of feature. Inference features are generated by performing model inference on custom models, allowing you to embed model predictions directly into your feature view. Lastly, calculation features allow for efficient row-level transformations in the source dataset, modifying raw data values to make them useful for feature engineering. Sometimes you may need more complex transformations beyond what's possible in a calculation feature. In these cases, Tecton lets you define a transformation function using a decorator pattern. This enables you to create powerful transformations in languages like Python, Pandas, or SQL. These decorated functions perform row-level operations like filtering, projections, and expressions to prepare raw data for feature computation. The transformation mode, defined by the mode parameter, specifies which type of transformation to apply. It could be Python, Pandas, or SQL-based, such as Snowflake SQL, PySpark, or Spark SQL. Finally, there's the timestamp field. This is the time field Tecton uses to perform time travel and calculate time-windowed aggregate features. The timestamp field helps ensure features are computed based on the correct data snapshots, which is crucial for point-in-time correctness. Now that we've covered the basics, let's dive into building and productionizing batch, streaming, and real-time data pipelines using Tecton's feature views and supporting objects. Let's start by looking into how to build a stream pipeline using Tecton. Unlike batch processing, where data is processed in large intervals, stream processing handles data as it arrives, allowing for immediate transformation and analysis. Stream processing is especially useful when applications need near real-time insights or inference. Tecton supports both pull-based streaming from sources like Kafka and Kinesis and push-based streaming through the Tecton Stream Ingest API. This flexibility allows teams to choose the best setup for their application needs. To create a streaming pipeline in Tecton, we start with the Stream Source object. A Tecton Stream Source unifies both stream and batch data for use in a stream feature view, enabling feature transformations across both real-time and historical contexts. The stream is configured through the stream config parameter, which is used to configure the raw streaming data source. In addition to the stream config, we can configure a batch data source, such as a data lake or data warehouse, using the batch config parameter. This allows Tecton to backfill historical data into the offline store, providing a comprehensive view of data over time. Once we have our sources defined, we use the stream source in a stream feature view object, where we specify features and transformations, just like we discussed earlier. After defining and persisting these objects with the Tecton CLI, Tecton automatically starts a stream materialization job. This job continuously pulls the latest events from the stream source and updates the online store with the freshest feature data. Alongside, Tecton also schedules incremental backfill jobs that read batch data from the batch source, populating the offline store with historical features. An initial backfill job even bootstraps the online store with current feature data. If you're using push-based streaming with Tecton's Ingest API, you can push events directly to Tecton. These events are then transformed, aggregated, and written to the Tecton online store, providing real-time feature updates. And in cases where no historical data source exists, you can enable offline logging on your push configuration. This lets Tecton log the raw events sent to the Ingest API to the offline log, building up a historical dataset over time from which you can compute features. Next, let's explore how to build pipelines in Tecton for use cases that rely exclusively on batch data. Batch data refers to a large volume of data that's collected, stored, and then processed in bulk at scheduled intervals. Unlike stream data, batch data isn't handled immediately as it arrives. Instead, it's aggregated over time and processed all at once, making it ideal for applications where real-time processing isn't critical. Batch data sources are also valuable as a source of historical data, allowing us to backfill feature data for accurate model training and analysis. To connect Tecton to your batch data sources, such as Hive, BigQuery, Snowflake, or Redshift, we use the batch source object. A Tecton batch source object provides the link to your batch data, enabling Tecton to access and process historical data whenever needed. Once the batch source is configured, we can use it with batch feature view objects. Batch feature views allow us to schedule incremental batch jobs that transform raw data and publish features to both the online and offline stores. This setup makes it easy to keep features updated in the online store for serving applications, while also ensuring a consistent historical record in the offline store for model training and experimentation. Tecton integrates with several batch and stream data sources out of the box, using a suite of configuration classes available in the Tecton SDK. However, if you need to connect to a custom data source, you can go beyond these built-in options by creating a data source function. Data source functions offer greater flexibility for connecting to underlying data sources. With a data source function, you can specify custom logic to connect to your raw data source and transform data as it's retrieved, applying any necessary filtering or pre-processing. Simply write a function that connects to your raw data source, performs the transformations you need, and returns a data frame. Then you can assign this function as the batch or stream config of your data source. To ensure security, Tecton also lets you securely store and retrieve credentials for connecting to these custom data sources through Tecton Secrets. Tecton's SDK offers decorators to streamline the process of writing data source functions. With the Pandas Batch Config Decorator, you can write a data source function that reads from your source and returns a Pandas data frame. When using Spark for larger scale batch processing, the Spark Batch Config Decorator allows you to create a data source function that returns a Spark data frame. And for streaming data, the Spark Stream Config Decorator supports custom streaming sources using Spark. Finally, let's look at how to build a real-time feature pipeline with Tecton, using data that's only available at request time. Real-time or request time data refers to data that's processed and returned immediately in response to a specific user or system request. Unlike stream data, which is processed continuously as it arrives, request time data is processed only when needed or on demand. This capability allows Tecton to produce feature data using data available exclusively at request time and to enrich materialized data in the feature store with additional request time data. To start building a real-time feature pipeline, we define a request source object. The request source specifies the schema for data that will be sent at request time. For example, we might define a request source that accepts the user's current transaction amount as input. Next, we can define a basic real-time feature view that uses this request source as an input. In this feature view, we could use a calculation feature to apply simple transformations to the request time data and produce features based on the current transaction. For a more dynamic real-time pipeline, we can combine this real-time feature view with a batch or stream feature view. Let's take an example using a stream feature view that calculates the average transaction amount of a user over the past 7 days. We can now configure the stream feature view as an additional input to our real-time feature view and use a calculation feature to check if the user's current transaction amount is higher than their 7-day average. Let's break down how Tecton makes this possible with just a few Python objects. Like we discussed earlier, once the stream feature view is applied, Tecton automatically starts a stream materialization job. This job reads from the streaming source and updates the online store with each user's latest 7-day transaction average. Now, after persisting the real-time feature view to Tecton, we can make a query to the Tecton feature server with the user's current transaction amount. Tecton retrieves the necessary feature values from the online store, performs the real-time transformations, and returns the enriched feature data, combining both materialized and request time data. Tecton's real-time feature pipelines can therefore enable powerful on-demand transformations by combining historical feature data with request time data. This flexibility ensures you have the latest, most relevant insights to drive decision-making in real-time applications. That wraps up our overview of building data pipelines in Tecton. We've covered the fundamentals of batch, stream, and real-time feature pipelines, and how Tecton helps transform raw data into powerful, production-ready features. To dive deeper, be sure to check out our documentation and other videos for more insights and best practices. Thanks for watching, and happy building!